6-3 Volumes of Prisms. The volume is defined as the amount of space taken up by a solid. The height on a prism or cylinder is going to be the distance between its bases. And the volume formula that we're going to use is going to be V equals BH, where your capital V is volume, your capital B is your base area, and your lowercase h is the height of the prism. So you would read this properly as saying volume equals base area times height. When I ask you what the formula is, I don't want to hear V equals BH. I want to hear the proper terms. Volume equals base area times height. We capitalize base area because it is an important concept. We capitalize volume. It's a big thing. Base area was a big thing. Height, it's a little thing. It's a little piece of the puzzle. Find the volume of this prism. What we have here is a rectangular prism. So to do this, we're going to have to first find the base area. The base area is the area of the base. This base is a rectangle. To find the area of a rectangular shape, we have to use a formula: area equals base times height. Now, we have three numbers to choose from here, but we only want the ones dealing with this blue base, which is going to be 3 inches and 6 inches. So I'm going to plug those in. I'm going to first say that since area equals base times height, we can say from there that base area also equals base times height. With the base area formula, we're going to plug in our 3 inches and our 6 inches. 3 times 6 is 18, and inch times inch is inches squared. Easy enough. Now that we have a base area, we can take and go from there to a quick commercial break, which helps you understand how these things work. 2 times 2 times 2 is 2 squared times 2, and 2 squared times 2 is 2 cubed. Where did I get these from? Hold on just a second, let me show you. Right here, your 2 times 2 is your 2 squared. And here's your other times 2 right there. And when you take 2 squared times 2, those two come together to be the 2 cubed. Likewise, 3 times 3 times 3 is the same thing as saying 3 squared times 3, with these two coming together here and that one there. And 3 squared times 3 is equal to 3 cubed. Since we know that information, let me jump back a little bit, went too far ahead. Since we know that information, we could say that inch times inch times inch is equal to inch squared times inch, and inch squared times inch is equal to inches cubed. Easy math. Now that we have that information, the understanding of how those work, we can come back over here and we can find the volume. The volume we know is equal to the base area times the height. Our base area in this problem we already found was 18 inches squared. We got that by doing the 3 inches times the 6 inches. Our height in this problem is the 8 inches. So from here, we're going to take and say volume equals 18 inches squared times 8 inches. 18 times 8 is 144. Inch squared times inch is inches cubed. So my volume is 144 inches cubed. All said and done, these problems are a lot easier than the ones we worked yesterday. The surface area ones were a lot of work because he had to make the nets. We don't have to make any nets here. We just find the base area, multiply it times the height. Now would be a good time for you to pause the recording and try this problem on your own. Let's take a look and see what you came up with. First thing we had to ask ourselves is what's the shape of the base, and the base is obviously triangular. Since we have a triangular base, we can say, well, what's the formula for the area of a triangle? Think about it, that you should already have written on your paper would be area equals base times height divided by 2. Therefore, we can say that base area is also equal to base times height divided by 2. With that information, I can go ahead and start working for my base area. I've got 6 different possible numbers, 3 feet, 4 feet, and 6 feet. The 6 feet has nothing to do with the triangle, though. And the 3 feet and the 4 feet do. They meet at right angles. Therefore, those are going to be my base and my height. Whoops, let me go back. I missed something here. So from there, I'm going to put my 3 feet times 4 feet divided by 2. That'll be 12 feet squared divided by 2, otherwise known as 6 feet squared. But I'm not done. That's just the base area. Now from there, I've got to go to the volume, which equals base area times height. The volume we just found out is going to be 6 feet squared times the height, which we have right here, of 6 feet. 6 times 6 is 36. Feet times feet is feet squared times feet is feet cubed. Circle your answer. Easy math. Anybody can do these things. Just simple little puzzles to put together. Here's another shiny one for you to work on. Go ahead and work all the way through it. Find the volume of this prism. Okay, so what do you come up with? First off, you ask yourself, what shape is a base? And the correct answer is that the base is going to be a trapezoid. Then you say, well, what's the formula for the area of a trapezoid? That was that tough one we had to learn that said that area is equal to 1/2 height times base sub 1 plus base sub 2. Therefore, we can also say our base area is equal to the same formula. From here, we're going to solve for base area. And it gets a little confusing, but not too bad. This height deals with the height of the prism. We don't want that. We want the height that deals with the distance between the parallel lines, which is 20 centimeters. Base 1 and base 2 are going to be your 70 and your 40 centimeters. So we're going to take and plug those values in, which you can see right here. I just moved the polyhedron down out of the way. From there, we're going to take and add the 40 and 70 together. Then, of course, we had choices on how to proceed. I chose to take and multiply the 20 times the 110 first and then half that. You may have found half of 20 and then multiplied it by the 110. Either way, we should have come up with the same exact base area of 1100 centimeters squared. Now that we have a base area, we can plug it into the volume formula. Volume is equal to base area times height. Volume is equal to 1100 centimeters squared times 50 centimeters. 1100 times 50 is 55,000, and centimeters squared times centimeter is centimeter cubed. Circle your answer. Easy math. Anybody can do this stuff. Just takes a little bit of time. Your opportunity to expand your mind tonight is page 384, numbers 1 through 3, 6, 7 through 9, 13, 11, 13, and 15.
Here we go again. Catfish grabbing is a sport that a lot don't understand. It's been around a long, long time throughout our southern land. The Indians brought it to us way before our time, and I think we'll keep it going with these grappling friends of mine. Let's go catfish grappling, you don't need a rod and reel. Let's go catfish grappling, you're sure to get a thrill. When you reach back in that hole, you'll be surprised at what you find when you're catfish grappling with these grappling friends of mine. If you're ever down in Dixie in the springtime of the year, just leave your cares behind along with your fishing gear.
You'll find that on a lake shore is a great place to unwind while you're catfish grabbling with these grabbling friends of mine. Let's go catfish grabbling, you don't need a rod and reel. Let's go catfish grabbing, you're sure to get a thrill. When you reach back in that hole, you'll be surprised at what you find when you're catfish grabbing with these grabbling friends of mine. Let's go catfish grabbling, you don't need a rod and reel. Let's go catfish grabbling, you're sure to get a thrill. When you reach back in that hole, you'll be surprised at what you find when you're catfish grabbling with these grabbling friends of mine.
I would.